9 wins in their last 11 games, 4-1 the final over the Rockland Boulders. And welcome back to Newman Outdoor Field for our post-game show here on 740 The Fan and live at Newman Outdoor Field. Red Hawk manager Doug Simonek joins us outside his third base dugout. Congratulations, Doug. Very well-pitched game, I thought, tonight. Taylor Stanton giving you six strong innings, and then Joe Harris and Nate Kilcrease looked very much in control of their stuff.
Yeah, Stanton was a little, you know, used up a lot of bullets in the first inning, and that really hurt him. Pushed his pitch count up to 55 in the third. We were trying to hope we could get him deeper in the game, 107 by the end. But, you know, he was efficient when he had to be, stayed out of big trouble, didn't put a lot of base runners on base, and was able to, you know, basically just hold him down until we could get to Harris, and then Kilcrease has filled in that closer's role pretty nice. So, yeah, the pitching was good. Held down a pesky, scrappy team. I mean, these guys, you don't know what's going to happen. They've added a new guy in their lineup, Rivera, and he looks pretty solid. So, very good job by our starting pitcher and our bullpen.
And, Doug, at the top of your order, Zach Penpraise was involved in everything you did offensively. He scored three runs. He stole a base. And then C.J. Rutherford, with whom we're going to speak here in a minute, had another couple of RBIs. How about your opportunistic offense tonight?
Well, I sat down this afternoon with Zach for 15 minutes in the office and just talked about fun. Let's play the game to have fun. Let's not get so upset when it's not going our way. He's had peaks and valleys. I mean, there's no question, but everybody on our team has peaks and valleys. Big thing for us is he's a catalyst. He's got to get on. Tonight he got on. He produced a couple runs for us. He played his kind of game. So, I mean, we need that. We don't necessarily need a batting average from him. We need him on base percentage, walks, get a hit here, find a way to get on base and create what he creates. And usually when he gets on base, he creates a lot of good stuff. So, I don't know. He's important. And CJ, you know, he's up there ripping. I mean, if you give him people on base, he's going to have a lash at it. So, I'm impressed. I mean, everybody, we ground this game out. This was a game that we were able to grind, and we were able to win it.
Tomorrow night, then, game three of this four-game series, Alex Caldera will take the hill for you against Bobby Blevins of Rockland. How about a preview of game three, Doug?
Well, we need Caldera definitely to get back on track. I mean, he's had a lot of go at St. Paul over the last 3 weeks, and he was tired of that. So we need him to get back to form like he was his first 6-7 starts of the year. If we can do that, I think he'll be fine. Blevins looks like a guy on their stat sheet that's been pretty solid for him all year. Looks like they can depend on him. So, you know, it should be another titanic battle. I mean, none of these games have been easy so far going through.
Absolutely not. Thanks so much, Doug. Congratulations on your 52nd win of the year.
All right, Scotty.
Doug Simonek with us on our post-game show here from Newman Outdoor Field. The skipper now leading this team to a 52-30 record through 82 games of the season. And here is the run producer, C.J. Rutherford. We haven't spoken to him for a while. And, C.J., way to go again tonight. You were 2-for-3, drove in a couple of more runs. And just how about the way this game played out, C.J.? Kind of a tight-to-the-vest game where there weren't a lot of runs scored, but the Red Hawks still found a way to win.
Yeah, I mean, Stanton gives us a chance every night. He's out there, he dominates, keeps runners off the base. Good upbeat tempo, and keeps you in the game.
CJ, you had RBIs in each of your last two at-bats. In the fifth inning, you came up and had a chance with two outs to bring home a run, and you did just that with a single up the middle. How about that at-bat? What were you thinking as you were up against Charlie Law at that time?
I was trying to hit a home run. I've runner in scoring position with two outs. I really take pride in two-out RBIs, and I was just trying to battle and hit a single. I mean, Zach's going to score on any base hit, so that's all I was trying to do.
You have 59 RBIs in 65 games played this season for the Red Hawks, CJ. You've been so good, and as you say, you pride yourself in driving in runs. And I know Doug Simonek will tell me sometimes in the dugout that you're talking to your guys and you're going to get an RBI a game. What makes you so good at being able to drive in runs?
Preparation. You got to watch the pitcher, know what he's doing. And when there are runners in scoring position, you got to bear down and take advantage because they come few and far between.
Hey, CJ, I have to ask you, you've been very good at second base as well. You made another nice play tonight to your right up the middle. on a force out at second base. And the team in general has fielded the ball so well this year. Talk a little bit about the Red Hawks defense.
Like you said, it's outstanding. From any outfielder, any infielder, and I mean, you put the ball in play and it's going to get caught. And I know for the pitcher standpoint, they got to feel good about that. They can attack the hitters. And it's just, I mean, you got to take pride in your defense, and that's how I go about it. But, I mean, we're just a good unit, I guess.
18 games left now in the regular season, CJ. Just how are the guys feeling in the clubhouse, your team now 22 games above the 500 mark?
We feel good. I mean, good, upbeat, locker room, loose. Even when we lose, you know, we know we're going to come back the next day and give them hell. So it's just you come out here and you want to win, and, you know, you fight for it.
I should ask you one more thing before I let you go, because it spurred on something you just said about the way the guys react to each other in the clubhouse, and I've seen it, of course, on the bus, too. Everybody seems to get along so well, and you were telling Doug Simonek a story earlier this season about just how good the camaraderie is. How is it for you and for the rest of the guys in the clubhouse?
I mean, I can't speak for everybody, but the majority of the team I know, I mean, everybody gets along, everybody hangs out on and off the field, so that's a big key. Probably one of the best chemistry teams I've ever played with, from top to bottom anyway.
CJ, thanks for the visit. Keep up the great work.
Thank you.
Yep, CJ Rutherford with us on the postgame show. The Red Hawks win it 4-1. The Red Hawks second baseman had a couple of RBIs. He was instrumental in this home win as the Red Hawks fell behind 1-0 in the top of the third, scored two runs in the bottom of the third, picked up single runs in the fifth and the seventh, and their pitching did the rest as Taylor Stanton, Joe Harris, and Nate Kilcrease hold down the Rockford order to seven total hits in a 4-1 final.